Hi everyone, my name is Efi Melista and I'm the Head of Field and Lab Operations at Omixon. And today I would like to talk to you about the Pippin Prep and what is the principle of the method. Let me explain to you how does this machine work. As you probably already know, we use an automated way to do, an automated method to do size selection. The machine is called Pippin Prep and it is made by Sage Science, which is a company in the United States. It's actually a very, very simple method, and sometimes I wonder why didn't I think of it beforehand, because I've worked with NGS for many, many, many years. It's a very basic principle. Essentially, the Pippin Prep machine looks exactly like this, like what you see here in the picture. The collection range that we set the machine up to collect is between 650 base pairs to 1300 base pairs. And at the end of the run, we expect approximately 40 microliters of size-selected library output. The machine uses these plastic cassettes that look exactly like this in the picture. Each cassette has 5 lanes. We only use 1 lane per run, but the cassettes are reusable and you can actually use the rest of the lanes at a different time. There is no limitation, so there is no waste. So how does this machine work? What is the principle of this method? Each lane looks exactly like what you see here in the picture. It's one long column. The green part is filled with agarose gel. It's a standard agarose gel. There is a branch point that it breaks into two, approximately halfway down the middle of the column. There is a port for the negative electrode on one side and 2 ports for positive electrodes on the other side. Note how on one of the branches there is no agarose gel, only on the top one there is one. There is also a loading port right here where the red is, that's where we load our library. And then there is a collection chamber on the side on the branch with the no agarose, and that's where the library gets collected in after the size selection. The idea is that we have 2 fluorescently labeled markers. One marker is a 50 base per fragment, and the second marker is 150 base per fragment. What we do is that we mix those two with our library, and we load the library and the marker mixture in this loading port where the red is right here. And then we turn on the current. As any typical electrophoresis, the library, which is essentially DNA, will start migrating from the negative to the positive. One important thing to note here is that the positive electrode only from the one branch, the top branch where the agarose gel is in, is turned on. As the markers are smaller fragments and they start migrating first, they will be detected by a laser point approximately at this point first. So the 50 base per fragment will be detected first, and then the machine will calculate how much time did it take for the 50 base per fragment to go from this point to this point. And it will make a note of that time point. Then the 150 base per marker will be detected second. And then the machine will do the similar calculation, calculating how much time did it take for the 150 base per fragment to go from this point to that point. Based on these 2 time points, the machine will calculate how much time does a fragment size of 650 base pairs that we want to start collecting from will take to reach the same point. When that time has come, the positive electrode from one branch will be turned off and the positive electrode on the other branch will be turned on. And as a result, the fragments that we want, instead of going into the agarose gel, will fall into the little collection chamber right here on the other side. This collection chamber has an impermeable membrane on the other side, which prevents the library from falling into the buffer that exists in here. And that's pretty much it. Isn't it a very smart method? It's very simple, it's completely hands-off. The runtime takes about 45 minutes, with the elution being approximately between 8 and 10 minutes. And then essentially in less than 1 hour, you have a size selected library without having done any hands-on work at all. And that's it. Thank you very much for watching us. If you have any more questions, feel free to contact us at support@omixon.com or go on our website for a lot more material and educational stuff. Bye!